Hi, welcome to this session on type of constraints. In this session, we will discuss not null, unique, and primary key constraints. Let's start this session. First type of constraint is null or not null constraint. To make a column mandatory or compulsory, we can apply this constraint during creation of table. By default, all columns are optional and they have null constraint. To apply this constraint, the syntax is column name, data type, size, and with this we can specify our constraint not null. Every constraint internally assigned a unique name by Oracle. However, we can give our own unique name to constraint by using keyword constraint, constraint name, but it is optional. Let us apply this constraint on student table. Here, roll number is not null. It means null is not allowed in this column and it is a compulsory column. Let us move to SQL interface to demonstrate this concept. Let us create student table with not null constraint. Check, we got error because student has already been exist. So let's first drop this table. Now create a new student table with roll number as not null constraint. Table has been created. To check its effect, let us insert a new record in this table. Now we have a roll number as a compulsory column. I have inserted row for roll number 1. If I make roll number as null and try to insert this value, I got error message that I cannot insert null into roll number. Fine, we have achieved our objective. To enforce uniqueness of the column or group of column, we can apply unique constraint. It removes duplicacy or repetition of data. In syntax, we have to write unique with their column name, data type, and size. Optionally, we can specify constraint name. Let us apply this constraint on a student table. Here, roll number has been made unique by applying this constraint. We can also specify our own constraint name during creation of table. Let us demonstrate this concept in SQL. Let us first drop earlier student table. Table has been dropped. Now let us create a new student table with the unique constraint on roll number. Table has been created. Insert a record of roll number 1 in this table. Record has been inserted. If I try to insert same record again in this table, it is not allowed. System raises an error message that unique constraint has been violated. Here, system is the username and sys underscore this number is the unique name assigned by Oracle to this constraint. If I try to insert 2, it is allowed, but repetency of this value is not allowed. It is important to note that null is allowed in unique constraint, and even we can store duplicate null values because null means unknown value and one null is not equal to another null. So that's why in unique constraint, you can store duplicate null values in the column. To make roll number and class combination unique, as in case of primary school database, we can use this statement. Here, unique is a table level constraint and it has been applied on roll number and class combination. We can specify table level constraint after specifying all the columns. We can also specify our own unique constraint name to this table level constraint. Let us demonstrate this concept in SQL. Let us create primary underscore student table where unique constraint has been applied on roll number and class combination. Table has been created. Let us insert some record in this table. I am going to insert record of roll number 1 in first class. It is allowed. If I try to insert roll number 1 in same class, it is not allowed. But roll number 2 is allowed in the same class. Roll number 1 can also exist in second class. Let us check this insertion. Yes, it is allowed. Roll number 2 can also exist in second class. So you can clearly check that here roll number and class combination is unique. If I try to insert same record, it is not allowed. And these are the records which we have inserted. So we have inserted roll number 1 and 2 in first class and roll number 1 and 2 in second class. You can check. Roll number can repeat, class can repeat, but combination of roll number and class is unique. Yes, we have achieved our objective. Up to this point, we have learned the concept of non-null and unique constraint. With non-null constraint, we can make a column mandatory or compulsory, but then repeated values are allowed in non-null constraint. We have unique constraint to enforce uniqueness of a column. But with unique constraint, column is not mandatory. It is still optional. But sometimes we wish to enforce both non-null and unique constraint at the same time on a column. And for this, the solution is primary key constraint. Primary key constraint on a column enforces uniqueness and non-null at the same time. Let us learn the concept of primary key constraint. Primary key constraint is a combination of both unique and non-null constraint. It is used to identify unique row of a table. If primary key is applied on a single column, then it is called simple key. And if it is applied on a combination of column, then it is known as composite key. Its syntax is column, data type, size, and we have to specify primary key. We can also give our own constraint name to this constraint. Let us apply this constraint to student table. Here, roll number is the primary key constraint. Let us execute this statement to demonstrate this concept. Here, I am going to create student table with roll number as a primary key. Table has been created. Let us insert record in this table. Record of roll number 1 has been inserted. If I try to store repeated value, it is not allowed. If I try to store null value in roll number, it is also not allowed. Of course, I can store record for roll number 2. Repeated value is not allowed. Null is not allowed. Yes, I have achieved my objective. To make roll number and class combination as a primary key in primary school database, we can use this statement. Here, primary key is a table level constraint and it has been applied on roll number and class combination. Let us demonstrate this concept. I am going to create primary underscore student table with roll number and class combination as its primary key. Let us insert some record in this table. I am going to insert record of roll number 1 in first class. It is allowed. Of course, repeated value is not allowed in the table. If I try to insert null in roll number, it is not allowed. Null is also not allowed in class. I can insert roll number 1 in second class and repeated values are not allowed. It means in primary key, both uniqueness and nominal constraints are applied at. Now let us summarize the concept we have learned in this session. In this session, we have learned the importance of nominal, unique and primary key constraint. We have demonstrated all these concepts through SQL commands. Now it is a time to practice it. All the commands used in this session are available as a script file for your ease. In next sessions, we will discuss check, foreign key and default constraints. Thanks for watching this video.